Initiating moisture.
This is not a tie dad. This is a professional wetness analysis of the new Cloverfield movie, Cloverfield Paradox. This is marketing done right. So if you didn't watch the Super Bowl and you haven't gone on the internet, you live under someone else's asshole and you haven't heard about this, I'm going to go ahead and fill you in. So the marketing for this movie consisted of one ad, a 30-second Super Bowl ad last night to promote the movie. Before that, no one even knew anything about it. So they announced the movie during the Super Bowl, and then immediately after the Super Bowl, it's available to stream on Netflix. That is fucking great. That is the kind of shit we need to see more of. That's very fun. It gets people excited and talking about it, except when Sega tried this with a Sega Saturn in the 90s at E3 and just said, here's the Sega Saturn, and this motherfucker's available to buy now, and nobody gave a shit. Here, a lot of people gave a shit, because Cloverfield is a big franchise. I'm a massive fan of the Cloverfield franchise, especially the first one. Back when that came out, and I was just a 13-year-old boy, I couldn't get off the internet looking up Cloverfield theories with the shit falling in the background of the carnival in the ocean. Oh, it's a baby clover monster. That was just a baby. I can't wait for Cloverfield 2, where the X-Men are gonna have to team up with Chris Angel to take down the mother. Just being super excited. 10 Cloverfield Lane was spectacular. I fucking loved it. The first two Cloverfields are great. And I'm sorry to say, this new one is just not. I just went from super excited to super disappointed, and that's really just the sentiment shared by everyone who saw this, from the diehard Cloverfield enthusiast to just old Pop Wiggleberry looking for a fun sci-fi movie on Netflix. This movie just disappoints in everything it attempts. As a self-contained sci-fi movie, it's competent. It's visually great with stellar acting across the board, but it's just silly and it's nonsensical. So let's go ahead and break this down. This movie used to be just called The God Particle, and then it got slapped with Cloverfield sometime during the editing and just kind of shoehorned in the script. It's sloppy, and it really feels like it was just shoehorned in here. It doesn't feel like it really has any place, nor does it answer anything. This movie just leads to more questions than answers for the Cloverfield universe. But the movie revolves around the world in an energy crisis, and to solve this, they go into space to collide the God Particle for infinite energy for the world to solve their issues. It goes wrong, and they get transported to another dimension, and this creates this Cloverfield paradox. And then reality's all kind of fucked up because the dimensions are colliding, and it turns into this Final Destination movie where people are getting killed by magnetic silly putty. It's just nonsensical. In one scene, a man loses his arm, and his arm becomes sentient and omniscient. The arm is telling them fucking secrets as it crawls around Adam's Family style. It's the goofiest shit. It's nonsensical and it's silly. There's no real tension here. There's just nothing really of value here. The movie attempts to be the genesis of the evil in Cloverfield 1 and 2, but it doesn't give you anything concrete. I'm all for ambiguity. I'm all for not holding your hand through a story and making you think on it, but this just gives you nothing, really nothing at all to go off of. The Cloverfield universe, the Cloververse, any theory can fit. You can justify any theory. I'm sure there's a convincing theory where Santa Claus is the puppet master. There's just nothing concrete. They give you absolutely nothing, and it's fucking frustrating. This movie just leads to a whole plethora of questions that you can't answer. And I know there's going to be that subgroup of Cloverfield connoisseurs, the virtuosos of Cloverfield code cracking, that come into the comments, well, it's because you're not thinking so hard. Did you even pay attention to 13.4 minutes into the movie where there was a small fart on the radio? That same fart was in Cloverfield 1, thus those two timelines are connected. No, don't try and give this more credit than it's due. This movie was ham-fisted with Cloverfield during pretty much the editing, just tiny things in the script to connect Cloverfields very loosely. It's not like this genius universe that's being built up here. It's just subtle things and then really just overreaching in your explanations on how they're connected. It's just sloppy. It's not well done. It's way, way, way too ambiguous. You can't connect these. But with the previous two Cloverfield movies, even if you didn't care about how it was all connected in the Cloververse, you were still left with this great movie. Cloverfield 1 was really all about the monster. If you didn't pick up on the subtle shit, it didn't matter. 10 Cloverfield Lane had this fantastic story until the end of the movie where a lot of people didn't like it. But they still had this great movie there. This one, it's just not a good movie outside of the very loose connections to Cloverfield universe that were ham-fisted in here. And I know that the argument is all of it is about the Cloverfield universe, but it really wasn't. Like I said, this was the God particle, had nothing to do with Cloverfield until some point during the editing and some point during the script revisions. Then they just kind of made it more geared towards Cloverfield in very sloppy ways, in my opinion. I think it has a great premise. I think it's a great idea. But by not giving you anything concrete or anything to really go off of to tie them together, you're just left with a confusing mess of answers, questions with no answers. And that's just my biggest complaint here, and also that the sci-fi thriller here is really lackluster. So let's plug this shit into the moist meter. I'm giving this movie a 45%. Like I said, it's a competent sci-fi thriller, not exactly my taste because it's so generic and offers really nothing new, but it is competent and it is decent at best. But it's just not a very good movie, and for Cloverfield movie that's supposed to explain everything, it explains one thing very badly. And it's just a disappointment in all possible aspects, really, in my opinion. So if you've seen the previous two Cloverfields, I would highly recommend watching this just so that way you can get a hard, hard, hard disappointment erection. And if you haven't seen any of them, and you just want like a kickback sci-fi thriller, don't really give a shit about ties to other Cloverfield movies, you might enjoy this one to some extent. That's it. See ya.